Good day, subscribers. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am Jeremy. This is the Financial Education Channel, and today we are talking about five great dividend stocks. Five stocks that I'm looking at, and I'm like, if I was just a dividend investor, these are five stocks that I would want to be in. So, how do I judge dividend stocks, and what's a great dividend stock? One, I'm looking for a company that's already paying a dividend. Two, I'm looking for a company that is going to probably be here 5 to 10 years from now. And what I just don't mean by just be here, but I mean they're going to be probably at least as profitable as they are now, if not more profitable in the future. And I'm thinking 5 to 10 years out on that, because if you're a dividend investor, you should probably think longer term. I'm also looking at, how much as a percent of their income are they already paying out to a dividend. And then lastly, I'm looking at their balance sheet. I'm looking at cash and I'm looking at investments and seeing, do they have a lot of money in cash and investments? Just in case the company has a little struggles here and there, or they need to expand into something, they have money around that they could go ahead and do that, and they don't need to cut that dividend. So these are the things I'm looking at, guys. Let's just go ahead and get right into this. Leave a thumbs up if you enjoy, guys. I hope you do. So the number one stock we're looking at is Apple. Apple, I would say, is my favorite dividend stock of them all. It's my favorite by far in the entire stock market. It deserves its number one. It's the only one I actually ranked in order in this video. The other two through five are not like in a specific order. They're just another four stocks I like. But Apple, the number one dividend stock in the world, in my opinion, because when I look at Apple 5 to 10 years out, I see no reason why they can't be at least as profitable as they are now, if not a lot more profitable in the future. When you look at, even if their revenue somehow went down, even if they started selling less iPhones, you know, maybe Google started to take some market share, things like that, and maybe they couldn't expand into new products. Even if that happens, the company has so much money and they're buying back so many shares that even if their net income goes down a bit, they're reducing the share count. So I see no reason why they cannot keep EPS around where it's at now, or they're probably going to expand it over time. It might not be a huge amount so here and there, but a little bit over time. So that's reason number one why I love Apple. Then I look at this, guys. They pay about a 1.64% yield currently. So for all these numbers, we'll just assume you got $100,000. So if you have $100,000 invested in Apple, you get $1,600 per year. But with Apple, you're probably going to get a lot more in the future. 5 to 10 years from now, it's going to be dramatically more, because Apple only pays out 26% of their earnings in dividends. That's an extremely low rate, guys. That is extremely low. Most dividend stocks pay 50%+. A lot of them 70%+. But I would say the majority of dividend stocks pay 50%+ of their EPS out, meaning for every dollar that comes in the company, as far as not just revenue, but every dollar that goes to that net income line, 50 cents of that at least is going out toward dividends. In Apple's case, out of every dollar they have on net income, only or EPS, only 26 cents of that is actually going to the shareholders in form of a dividend. So Apple, as long as they can stay just as profitable as they are now, if not get more profitable, they have an immense, immense ability to expand the dividends over the coming years, guys. And I mean, they could double the dividend and only be at a 50% payout ratio, which is still just an average payout ratio. Some of the stocks we're going to look at today are paying already 80, 90% of their dividends out. So Apple, they're going to expand that dividend massively over the coming years. Now, what I also like with Apple is they have a ridiculous balance sheet. They have $20 billion in cash, $46 billion in short-term investments, $170 billion in long-term investments. That is sick. This company has more money than it knows what to do with. They have so much money that they can do a huge share buyback. They can expand that dividend drastically. They can invest in as much research and development as they could ever possibly imagine, and still have so much money that they still don't even know what to do with it, guys. So this is my number one dividend stock by far. If there's one stock and I just wanted to collect dividends on over the next 5 to 10 years, I would pick Apple over any stock by far, and it's not even close. It's not even close between them and any other company out there. Next up, we're looking at Coca-Cola. So let's look at its business model. They sell soda. They sell pretty much every drink you possibly imagine. Soda sales might go down in the US,
They're going up international markets. I would say they're going to be just as profitable now, or 10 years from now, as they are now, and things like that. I mean, I don't see Coca-Cola going anywhere. Maybe let me know, guys. So, in Coca-Cola's situation here, guys, the one thing I do not like is they have a super high payout ratio right now. They're paying out about almost 94% of the EPS they have coming in is going out toward dividends. That's the one thing that caught my eye right off the bat that I do not like about Coke. However, Coke does pay over a 3.5% yield, which is fabulous. They pay $1.48 per share. So basically, if you have $100,000 invested in Coca-Cola stock, you're going to get $3,500 per year. And that's unless they, of course, raise it, and then you'll get even more. But as of right now, you get $3,500 per year if you have $100,000 invested in it. So it's a really good dividend stock. The only thing I don't like about this one is the payout ratio is already super high. So they're going to need to definitely improve profitability in the future if they want to expand that. Because once you get to 100%, then there's nothing left to pay out at that point. Now, with Coke, I love how much money they have in this balance sheet. They have $8.5 billion in cash, over $13 billion in short-term investments, over $17 billion in long-term investments. This company is absolutely loaded up. They are absolutely loaded up on cash and investments and things like that. So they have plenty of money to do share buybacks if they want, pay out dividends, those kinds of things. Even if the company comes on a little hard times here and there, they have plenty of money to do with a lot of different things, guys. So that's what we got there. Next one up, we're looking at Procter & Gamble. So Procter & Gamble, go to your local Walmart, Target, grocery store, anything. Look on the back of Pampers diapers or, you know, your most popular shampoo brand or soap brand. It's probably a Procter & Gamble product. I mean, they own some of the biggest brands in the world. And they own 50, 100 of the biggest brands in the world, from Tide to Pampers to, I mean, it's insane how many different brands they own. It's really insane. So, when I look at their business, they're not going anywhere. Now, their payout ratio is around a 77% ratio right now. So they're paying out about 3/4 of their EPS out in dividends. So that's about right for a company this size. 3% yield. So basically, if you have $100,000 invested in this company, you will get $3,000 per year. $2.68 is what they actually pay out. That's very nice. And then I look at their balance sheet, $7 billion in cash, $6 billion in short-term investments, and they have no long-term investments. So basically, the company has plenty of money around to, you know, pay out the dividend even more in the future. They have a bunch of brands that aren't going anywhere. Their brands are going to be sold just as much, if not more, 5 to 10 years from now than they are now. So when I look at Procter & Gamble, extremely safe company that's not going anywhere. They pay out a good dividend already, and they're, as long as they get more and more profitable as time goes on, they'll just keep raising it here and there, and you'll get a bigger yield over time. The fourth stock up. You guys know this is actually one of my favorite stocks in general, Wynn Resorts. So Wynn Resorts, for you guys that don't know, it's a resort company. They're the highest of the highest end casinos, you know, everything, the entire resort experience you could possibly imagine. They have resorts in Vegas here. They have resorts out in Macau. They're the highest of the highest end. They're the creme de la creme. They're the Louis Vuitton of resorts. The Louis Vuitton of resorts. That's how I would compare them. So their business model, they're probably going to be just as profitable in the future or now, excuse me, in the future as they are now. I see no reason why their business wouldn't, unless all of a sudden Las Vegas somehow doesn't turn into the, or Vegas somehow goes from being the tourist capital of the world to like no one comes here. I mean, what are the chances of that? And then unless no one goes to Macau, which Macau is like one of the hottest spots to go if you live in China or any part of Asia. So unless that happens, which is probably not going to happen, like less than a 0.0001% chance, they're going to be just as profitable in the future as they are now. So when I look at Wynn Resorts, I see a company that they pay out just under a 2% yield. So basically, if you have $100,000 invested in it, you'll get about $2,000 per year. Now, with this company right now, they're paying out 84% of their earnings in dividends. But what we know about Wynn Resorts is they just opened Wynn Palace, which is going to be their by far their most profitable resort out of them all, out of all of them they own. So their earnings are going to go up substantially, which is going to allow them the ability to then go ahead and raise that dividend. And they're in a type of business that with capital structure, you do not necessarily need all that money all the time. You can pay out big, huge, fat dividends as he has in the past. Because basically, when you open a resort, then you have a lot of debt to pay off, and you pay that off slowly over time. But at the same time, you're not going to have another resort probably open for a while. So there's not a lot of capital needed. And then all of a sudden you finally are like, okay, now we're going to open the next $2 billion resort, and then you start funneling money into that. But in that time and space in there, you can pay out huge dividends. So, and then I look at their balance sheet. They have over $2.4 billion in cash, which is a lot for a company of their size. They have about $173 million short-term investments. They have $128 million in long-term investments. So I look at Wynn. I see a company that should be much more profitable in the future. I see a company that already pays out good dividends. I see a company that, which we didn't even kind of talk about here, that has a great dividend track record of paying out huge dividends and consistent dividends. And I see a company that has a good balance sheet. So last one up, number five, McDonald's. McDonald's, for those of you guys who do not know and you're under a rock somewhere, McDonald's is a fast food restaurant that serves burgers, salads, pretty much everything you possibly imagine. They'll sell whatever people are buying, they'll sell it at McDonald's, okay? So 5 to 10 years from now, see no reason why McDonald's can't be the same amount of profitability as they are now, as they will be in the future. No reason why it shouldn't be. So when I look at McDonald's, I see a company that pays a 3% yield currently, $100,000 invested, you're going to get $3,000 per year. I see a company that's payout ratio is about 66, which is on the lower side of most of the companies we looked at other than Apple. They have a lowest one we've looked at here, so they definitely have some room to raise that dividend. Lastly, they have $1.2 billion in cash, no short-term investments, long-term investments of about three-fourths of $1 billion. So they have plenty of money around McDonald's. So company that should be more profitable in the future, company that has relatively a lower payout ratio than most of the stocks we looked at, so they have room to raise it, and lastly, they have a good balance sheet. So those are my five favorite dividend stocks. Those are the five stocks that if I just had to throw my money at five stocks and I could not sell them for the next 5 years, and I wanted to collect dividends on that and have that money reinvested, those are the five stocks personally I would do, because I see them all being more profitable in the future. I see them all paying out bigger and bigger dividends as time goes on. So that's my take on it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this. Let me know in that comment section, what stocks are your favorite for dividends? Are any of these fives in it? What do you think about these fives? I would love to hear from you guys in that comment section. I love reading those comments. Even if I don't respond, I still read almost every single comment. I read like 90%+ of comments. Don't respond to a lot of them now because it's so many, but I still read them, guys. So I love seeing your guys' opinion on this stuff. So anyways, thank you for watching today, guys. If you have not subscribed yet, you may want to. We talk personal finance on the channel. We talk entrepreneurship. I'm an actual business owner. I give away so many business tips. We talk the stock market the most of anything on this channel. Thank you for watching, guys, and have a great day.